Welcome to another highly questionable extravaganza. What's good today, Bo?
Like, we're still talking about Charles Oakley, but he hadn't even hit nobody new. Hit somebody, Oak.
Dale, papi.
How much trouble are the Cavs in now that Kevin Love is out for 6 weeks?
They really need Kevin Love. They just don't need him over the next 6 weeks. We know the Cavs are the best team in the conference going away. Even though they're weakened, then they'll be weakened without him. As long as he's in playing shape by the second round of the playoffs, this doesn't actually matter that much.
You're not doing this right, Dan. This is the part where we all try to turn this into a Melo for Cleveland deal. The door is wide open. Kevin Love is going to be gone for 6 weeks. Don't you need to get Melo before the end of those 6 weeks? Of course, the answer to that is no. Of course, it's not going to happen. But that's the fun that this is going to start. Like it or not, Kevin Love matters. But as he said, only in a couple of months. They could lose just about every game while he is out, and I don't think it would matter in the end.
I do think it's about time, though, that we marvel at the total indestructibility of LeBron James. That not only do his teams not go get destroyed, he never physically goes down for even these 6 weeks as a player a lot younger than him just did.
By the way, also kind of indestructible, the Golden State Warriors, because they're good players, never miss time like this.
Well, maybe he's not hurt. Maybe he's just tired of playing with LeBron, you know, Kevin. You know?
Maybe he doesn't want to be traded.
That's right.
That's the one way to do it. If you don't want to be traded, ow, my knee, MRIs, please.
That'd make him the first person who was like, nah, I don't want to leave Cleveland.
Was it important for the NBA commissioner to get involved in the Oakley Dolan beef?
I'm sorry, I didn't realize Michael Jordan was the NBA commissioner. Oh, you're talking about Adam Silver, though. We got a statement from the league saying that Michael Jordan helped bring everybody together, and they've made peace. Charles Oakley is now no longer banned from Madison Square Garden, though God knows why anyone would want to go there to watch the Knicks. Did the commissioner have to do this? Kinda, yeah. The reason he kinda had to do this is Jim Dolan was gonna keep trying to fix it, and every time he tried to fix it, he made the situation more ridiculous. Somebody had to come in and say enough.
We talked to Oakley on the radio today. He said Michael Jordan was trying to get a hold of him while he was in handcuffs, and he was asking people, can you take these handcuffs off me so I can take this call from Michael Jordan? He also said that he hasn't really forgiven Dolan, and if Dolan invited him back, even though he apologized to him and they apologized to each other, he would not immediately take that invitation back. This isn't done, but he needed to do this, the commissioner, because we were all laughing at the Knicks and it was embarrassing, and it's his job to keep away the embarrassing. Bad job by Silver, though. I was kind of enjoying the embarrassing.
Well, Michael Jordan, he left the golf course.
I don't think letting somebody play through is the same thing as leaving the golf course. Hey, give me a second. I just got to handle this right fast. Y'all go ahead.
I got to make a quick call. Oakley's in handcuffs.
Is LaMarcus Aldridge right to complain about the Spurs only getting one All-Star?
It wasn't really a complaint. We can make it a complaint. He was asked a question, and he wondered about the Warriors, only a couple of games better than the Spurs, getting four All-Stars when they've only got one. But I think all of us would say that Kawhi Leonard is the only All-Star on that team. Even as LaMarcus Aldridge's numbers are better across the board than Draymond Green's, we all consider the Spurs more of a team than any one star, and Kawhi Leonard is probably the only star on that team.
Yeah, but here's the thing about saying it wasn't really a complaint. When the dude who's not an All-Star is saying that the team should have had more All-Stars and he's been an All-Star before, it sounds kind of like he's complaining that he himself is not an All-Star. Now, there's no one I could point to that I could say on the Spurs other than Leonard absolutely should be an All-Star. Does he have the right to complain? I mean, yeah, I also have the right to laugh at him for doing so.
Hey, LaMarcus, newsflash. The Spurs are boring.
Okay, there you go. I mean,
there is that. And they try to be boring, and then people get mad at us for being bored.
I mean, it wasn't really news or a flash. It was neither of those things, but okay, it's the truth.
Is UConn winning 100 in a row a bigger achievement than winning another title?
UConn won again. I mean, I don't know what else there is to say other than they won again. They won 100 straight games. And part of what's impressive about them winning these 100 straight games is it's not like Geno's avoiding the competition. They go find the best teams in the country to play, and they beat them by a zillion points. If they get another title, good for them. But there's something about being able to say you won 100 games in a row that goes beyond any stack of titles you could have.
Especially when you consider that before Geno got there, the program hadn't won 100 total games. And now they're winning 100 in a row. They're winning most of them by double digits. Bobby had it right yesterday. South Carolina didn't win, but South Carolina did cover. Bobby put the house on them. The fact that South Carolina even kept that within 11 points is something of an accomplishment. This is a dynasty for all time. It's an amazing achievement. I don't know if anyone outside of UConn cares, but it is amazing that they're able to dominate the sport this way when single-game sample sizes even get Alabama football knocked off.
Should the addition of Serge Ibaka satisfy an angry Kyle Lowry?
Oh, the producers are quick on their feet because the Raptors have traded for Serge Ibaka before this question read something along the lines of, Dwayne Casey, is this a shot at Dwayne Casey? You tell me whether this is a shot at Dwayne Casey and whether they're trying to get Serge Ibaka to satiate their star.
What went wrong in the fourth quarter there on both ends?
I gotta help you like that.
Everything. I did everything. Keep putting in the same situations over and over, and they're not being successful. Something got to give, or something got to change.
Any idea what that is?
Or I have an idea, but I'm gonna, you know, keep my mouth shut. Keep it very, you know, professional.
Nothing passive-aggressive at all about that, by the way. Now, if the problem is in the fourth quarter, Serge Ibaka's not going to be the guy to fix that. He probably makes them better. I'd rather have him than Terrence Ross. But was that a shot at Dwayne Casey? It doesn't matter if it's a shot at Dwayne Casey, because it sounds like a shot at Dwayne Casey, because we all know when it comes to X's and O's, Dwayne Casey isn't that guy. So whether it's a shot doesn't even matter, because it's still Dwayne Casey.
That's got to feel good for Kyle Lowry, though. He says in his press briefing, something's got to change. Next thing you know, the thing that's changing is Terrence Ross's uniform. You go on and get out of here. I want Serge Ibaka. Bring him in. He's better than you are.
Yeah, Terrence Ross has got to be like, dawg, next time you need to be more specific about what it is that you want.
Wow, they got Serge Ibaka. Now they might lose six games instead of five in the second round.
Yeah.
That's an improvement.
Hey, they made the conference finals last year. Didn't they go six?
Where they lost in six games, yeah.
Are you buying the report that Floyd Mayweather Conor McGregor fight is all but dumb?
Boy, he held on that Floyd Mayweather like the DJ was stretching the note out or something like that. Anyway, that's what we have. The Sun newspaper in Britain, which our British producer describes as kind of a rag. They say this fight's about done, but Stephen A. Smith says that he has talked to Floyd Mayweather and that the fight is almost a deal, and I simply cannot believe that the sanctioning body of any state will allow this to happen, because Floyd fighting Conor McGregor in a boxing match is effectively Floyd fighting a dude off the street. You can't let a dude off the street fight Floyd Mayweather.
Oh, you can if there's a lot of money involved and a lot of people will pay for it, and a lot of people will pay for it, even though McGregor is going to be an overwhelming underdog. And here's why it's smart for both of them. Floyd will get a lot of money for a really easy fight. Conor McGregor will get a lot of money, more than he'll make in the UFC, with less danger, because Floyd Mayweather is just going to hit him with a bunch of feathers. It's going to be less dangerous for Conor McGregor for more money. If that's the case, you try and make that fight happen.
You say it about people who are going to pay for it. You know who's really going to pay for this fight? America, because this is going to tear us apart. You are going to find out that so many people are Irish that you never knew were Irish if this fight comes around. I don't want it.
You say Mayweather punches like feathers?
That's right.
Really?
That's right.
Hey, Mayweather, did you hear my son say? Did you hear what he said? He says you punch like feathers. You know, you come down here, you fight him, you know? Show him that he's wrong.
Look, he'll knock me out, but he's going to be hitting me in the belly.
He'll knock you out. He'll jump off the ground and knock you out with one punch.
Come on, he weighs 140 pounds.
And he'll knock your big out.
I mean, probably, but just with body shots, and it'll take him about 10 rounds to do it.
He'll knock your big
He's
out like
defense.
That.
He's going to be playing defense.
A defense against
that's
you?
That's all he does. That's right.
He's going to play defense against
defense.
You?
That's right. Like, come on. Let's go.
Like, fight you'll be like if Brian Scalabrine showed up to hoop against you. Yeah, you got jokes until he dunks on you.
I'd hold him. I hold him by the forehead.
You will run around the ring so much that you get so tired and you just fall down.
That's
true. The end of the fight,
right.
You know?
Soaked in my own urine. That's right. I'll take that payday.
You'll be 147 by the end of the fight.
I'll take that payday.
Coming up next on Highly Questionable.
Oh, wow.
Ouch.
Super dad.
Oh, he's mad about the free throw.
Oh, yeah, I mean, is this dude, like, new to the team or something like that? Like, I feel like you should know who's the dude that you can't dap up after the free throw, right?
Time to play the game that this glad he won't be alone on Valentine's Day. Do you question?
He'll be with your mom. See, it's a good thing this time. You give us topics and events and we question them.
Do you question if Dario Saric asked for it?
Oh, yeah, we're going to watch the Sixers game. Rickwan Holmes is at the free throw line. I'm guessing he plays for the Sixers because I ain't never heard of that dude.
Sixers won last night.
Yep, he plays for the Sixers. Oh, wow.
Ouch.
Super dap.
Oh, he's mad about the free throw.
Oh, yeah, I mean, is this dude, like, new to the team or something like that? Like, I feel like you should know who's the dude that you can't dap up after the free throw, right? Because at first I was going to say Sarge is not from here. He's getting familiar with, like, you know, the dap etiquette. But that's a time where you still go and give the dap. My man wasn't here for it.
At least he didn't leave him hanging.
Oh, here we go. Remember this?
Yes, I do remember this. but I think this is better.
A young Andrew Bogut.
Yeah.
Looking for dap, finding no dap. There's also one where he dapped himself. Why? Because apparently no one liked Andrew Bogut.
Do you question whether this race should be rerun?
800-meter indoors in Ireland. We've got fast people. You know, I learned today that a hippo is just as fast as Usain Bolt. I just learned that today. That's true.
Shout out to Ron McGill.
Yes, sir.
Whoa!
Oh!
Oh, come on, man.
Oh,
that's messed up.
Oh!
Wasn't there a little thing off the infomercial that you could wrap around your leg like that and you'd hop over it and get your exercise?
How does that not happen more often, by the way? When they've got all those field events near the track, things like that, I'm surprised these guys don't get hit by a javelin every so often.
Well, I'm willing to guess that at their other indoor venues, they account for the possibility something like that might happen. That's poor planning.
I feel like you should name that guy the winner just anyway, just because degree of difficulty, like in diving.
I think that the pole vaulter might have had some money on that race, buddy.
Oh, yeah.
He got plenty to lose there.
Yeah. The biggest surprise is that he didn't have money on the race. I expected that damn banana to start ringing.
You don't know he didn't have money on that. You don't know.
Do you question Brian giving it the second go?
They say this dude is some kind of YouTube scientist. Either you're a scientist or you're not, so I'm guessing he's not a scientist, and now he's going to try to crack an 80-foot bullwhip.
Hello, today
was
we're
it a parking lot of Holiday Inn Express or something?
Where's he going to hit himself? Where's he going to hit himself?
Whoa!
There! You better be careful.
No, stop. That's enough.
Yeah, that's enough.
That scares the hell out of me.
Yeah. No, Brian!
Yes, Brian. There it is. How about some of that for you, Brian?
Did you just whip yourself in the keister?
Yes.
Yeah, that's
twice?
Lovely right there.
Oh.
Well, that is by far one of the stupidest things I've ever done in my life. I think I was muscling it way too hard.
Yeah, that dude right there, he's a scientist.
That's how you get the YouTube in front of scientists.
They got science at every school, man.
Yeah. The school of YouTube doesn't have a science department.
That's not even the most stupid thing this guy has ever done.
This guy has done something dumber than that.
That's right.
Hello, I'm going to touch the electric fence while standing on wet grass
what?
And bare feet.
You're going to do what? Wet grass and what? Ouch.
For the love of God.
Please
man.
Do it again and hold on tight.
Come on, Dana Holgerson. Do better.
You're my fire, the one desire. Believe me when I say I want it that way. But we are two worlds apart, can reach to your heart when you say that I want it that way. Tell me why, ain't nothing but a heartache. Tell me why, ain't nothing but a mistake. Tell me why, I never want to hear you say I want it that way. Highly questionable is broadcast from the Clevelander Hotel on beautiful South Beach, Miami. Time to play the game that smells love in the air, see? Oh, no.
Tell us what's on television tonight. You know he's going to be intrigued.
Wait, that's not love. That's...
On MSG Plus, Islanders and Maple Leafs.
The only way we cover hockey around here is we go to fights, right? It feels like, unless it's a guy sliding into the goalposts and hitting his junk. We got McQuaid, Martin fighting.
Matt Martin. Saturday night's all right for fighting.
GTB.
Two veterans. Pugilist who can really throw Martin with a couple
oh,
of quick jabs.
Yeah, goes there, these are, look at that. Tailor the tape right there. They had enough time to get that graphic up.
McQuaid with the left jab. Martin with another hook. McQuaid
yeah,
wild
look at the
play
by play guys.
Blows.
They're calling a boxing match.
Knocks Martin's head off. Martin comes back at it. Martin connects with a big right.
Yeah. These are veteran pugilists.
Just
this is a long fight, man.
The fact that we call them veteran pugilists, by the way.
Right. Oh, there it is.
Boy.
That's the ending. He was done. Yes, look at that. Both sides. Both sides with the applause. Respect for the situation. Titanic tilt, blood from the ear. Bomani, are you intrigued?
Must be nice. I will also say this. Head injuries, we care about them unless it's a good fist fight. Yeah. Then all bets are off.
Fun concussion. Bobby, are you intrigued?
Oh, CC, I'm very intrigued. Happy Valentine's Day.
Yeah, too much
that's
love.
Right,
too
that's much right. That's right. Yeah, there we go.
I don't know why that dude had his hands down, though. Also, helmet free versus guy with helmet. Helmet free is hustling back.
Yes. Valentine's Day, here's a fist in your ear.
Hey, here are the kids.
Kids fighting for Valentine's
Whatever they call kids out. In Russia, or whatever Russia-like country they're in.
Don't leave the kids out on Valentine's Day. Let's include them.
On MSG Buffalo, Sabres and Senators.
Oh, we continue with our exhaustive expertise in hockey by showing you yet another fight. This time the goalie's involved, though. Watch this. You're not supposed to do this. You're not supposed to mess with the goalie. Takes a shot. Yeah, everyone knows that.
Whoa!
Yeah, how about some of that? You mess with the goalie, you're going to get some of this. Yeah, that, you don't do that.
Although the goalie, after the goalie went ahead and pushed him and punched him, I feel like the goalie should have fought it out himself.
Yeah, nope.
Also, is number 41 sole purpose on the team to do stuff like that?
41 is giant. Fuck you, man. Bomani, are you intrigued?
I mean, they going to do that? If so, you know, whatever.
Bobby, are you intrigued?
Oh, CC, I'm very intrigued. Happy Valentine's Day.
Yay!
I was actually hoping I could throw two of myself, but I couldn't come up with nothing to talk about.
Dad, look at my dad right there. Throwing punches that wouldn't hurt anybody.
Well, I said that dude needed to get his face.
Look at the kids right there. You know, they're also having a lot of fun there.
Yeah.
Happy Valentine's Day to everybody.
It's almost like he forgot that part with the kids in the video the last time we ran it and
he
talked
He's
about
old,
that.
He's old, man. He did. He forgets.
On ESPN2, Virginia Tech and Pitt.
No, thank you. You tried to sell that with enthusiasm with that Pitt. Absolutely not. But let's check in on Virginia Tech and Virginia. Virginia had a big lead in this game, and it ended up going into overtime. Oh, Josh, that hurts right there. And, of course, as soon as that happened, you know what was going to happen. Virginia's going to lose because they lost in double overtime. Of course. Bomani, are you intrigued?
The only thing I really know about the Virginia basketball team is those two dudes I saw running by the basket, and I didn't know Charlottesville was going through a barber strike. Like, there's nothing y'all can do for those young men to help them tighten up a little bit.
Bobby, are you intrigued?
Oh, CC, I'm very intrigued. Maybe the same thing will happen in this game now. You know, I ball hanging in there, never dropping in, just staying there. You know, I'm telling you something. That's something that you very seldom you see in a basketball game. You know what I mean? That's right. Ball hanging in there, not dropping in or dropping down or dropping in, whatever the case might be. You know?
That feels like what Virginia basketball has been for about the last 10 years. It feels like that.
On Fox Sports 1, the Westminster Dog Show.
You guys want to see a beagle named Mia crush an obstacle course? You want to see it, Bobby?
Of course I like dogs.
All right, Bomani.
You like dogs,
like
Bomani. You like dogs. Let's bring it in.
As a family.
As a family.
Let's watch. Go, Mia.
Go, Mia.
There we go. Come on. There we go. I was waiting for that.
Let's go, Mia. Pick it up.
Don't be a beagle.
Mia's going to go to the bathroom. Come on, Mia.
Yeah. I think Mia was trying to check out a little bit of
Mia's board is different. Mia. Mia.
There we go. Now they're on track.
Bomani, how can you see during this? This is adorable. Probably not a winning time, I don't think, there.
Oh, we lost the bar right there.
I feel like I've seen Michael Beasley do some of this stuff during an NBA game.
Hi, how's everybody? Somebody want a picture? Yeah!
I mean, after all, a beagle
won a show a couple Come years on, ago. Bomani, not even a smile? Nothing? Nothing? Look at me.
Why y'all making this dog do this? Clearly the dog doesn't want to do this. The dog would rather lick his booty, but no. Y'all just going to make him run around on camera.
Yeah. Yay, for Mia!
Yay, Mia!
And That is 66 seconds of television that we didn't have to do. Mamani, are you intrigued?
That crowd is a room full of people who bring their damn dolls to the Apple store, and I hate every single one of them. We'll be sitting up at a restaurant with a dog bowl. Let the dog stay at home.
Poppy, are you intrigued?
Oh, see, I'm very intrigued. Listen, but everybody's talking about that dog, but nobody's giving credit to that trainer. You know, that trainer worked hard to make that dog go around in that obstacle course. Boy, I'm telling you something. You got to give her a lot of credit, too.
That trainer couldn't let that dog go 1 minute without licking his own behind.
My father understands this because my father's own dog doesn't listen to him at all.
That's right.
Doesn't listen to him at all. He calls Nomo, Nomo won't come. He understands this.
That's all the time we have for today. Thank you for watching.
We will talk to you tomorrow, the right time, with Bomani Jones, 4 to 7 Eastern, ESPN Radio.
Gracias. See you mañana.
I kind of sniff my butt, too, and relieve myself,
All right,
you know?
Yeah, you could do that. Yeah, let's go ahead and end on that note.